I'm giving away this awesome LEGO ARC Trooper 5's minifigure when we hit 1,000 subscribers. The only thing you have to do is like this video, subscribe to my channel and leave your favorite LEGO Star Wars minifigure down in the comments below. Today we will be reviewing the 2024 LEGO Star Wars R2-D2 set. Given set number 75379, this set comes with 1,050 pieces and will cost you $100. And I bought this set for one reason. The exclusive LEGO Star Wars 25th Anniversary minifigure, Darth Malak. Seeing the release of this set back on March 1st kinda surprised me, since we already got a buildable UCS set of the R2-D2 back in 2021. That's still on the shelves for $240. But I don't mind it that much. I mean, now we have a cheaper option that will still give you the experience of a buildable R2-D2, which is great. But we will touch on whether or not you should buy this version or the more expensive UCS set of R2-D2. Now without further ado, let's start building. Finishing up the building process, we are left with this awesome R2-D2. Starting off with the minifigs included in this set, we have this Darth Malak minifig. They really knocked it out of the park with this minifig. They added a lot of detail to his torso, legs, and even made a custom jaw piece just to make him as accurate as possible to the original character. Personally, I really love this minifigure. The only improvement I could think of is something like dual model legs, but that's not that big of an issue. This minifig was the main reason why I bought this set, so I'm really happy to add him to my collection. Next up, we have this awesome R2-D2 minifigure that comes with his own display that gives us some details about him. They did some amazing work on the printing of this minifigure, and they even added a back print to him, making this a high-end version of R2-D2. One amazing upgrade they have done when you compare it to the LEGO R2-D2 UCS set from 2021 is that the display plate now has the image with all the info printed on the piece instead of having to apply a sticker to the plate. This is, in my opinion, a small but great detail that really elevates the quality of this set. Moving on to the main build, I'll start off with his head. The head can spin a full 360 degrees and it really looks accurate to the real character. One of the great features on this head is all the outward studs that really add depth and detail to the head. And when you compare this version with the 2021 version, you can see it's definitely an improvement. When we take a look at the legs, we can see they really did a great job on the detailing. You can see that when you put him down and try to move it, there's some articulation in the main legs, while the third leg makes it seem like he's really moving by himself, which is pretty awesome. The third leg is just an attachment that you can put on or off, so you can choose yourself how you want to display it. The front side of this R2-D2 comes with the option to use some attachments that are included in this set. You'll have to remove the 1x8 tiles on the front side to add these attachments to the build. These make it look like R2 has his hatch opened up, trying to grab or reach something, which make the display of this set feel a little bit more interactive. Next to that, we also have this periscope that we can put on top of his head to make it seem like he's looking for something or someone. So we got a wide selection of options how we want to display him, or if you're a kid, how you can use all these play features with your imagination. And I hope we will see more use of these kind of features in upcoming sets. When I compare this version with the bigger and more expensive UCS version of R2-D2, I think I like this version more. In my opinion, it has a more accurate look, some pretty nice detailing, and is a whole lot cheaper than the UCS version. Sure, if you want to go all out and have the big version of this character, you should definitely buy the UCS version. But if you're just a regular fan of these buildable character sets like me, I think you're better off with this cheaper version. Plus, you get an awesome Darth Malak minifigure with it. And with that in mind, we have come to the end of this video. Let me know down in the comments below which version you prefer most. If you enjoyed this video, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to my channel for more set reviews, minifig unboxes, and other amazing content. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. May the bricks be with you.